Right, the game has started. It's my opponent to go first. I have a vowel-heavy rack. I'll be looking to get rid of definitely one of the I's, a U, possibly an F, the F maybe. I have fairy onto an E, F-A-E-R-I-E, shocking rack leave, I don't think I'd play that. Unifier, almost, if the A was an N. Okay, what have I got to work with? An L and a C, as far as the consonants go. Fuki. Nah, I've got to get rid of more vowels. Fluia. A-I. Okay, I'll draw the Q and the Z. I have Caddy and Cade on my rack. I have Darcy. Paid there. 38, or Pard, keeping the eye, 38 is pretty good. Takes out that hot spot, and then I've got QI here for next turn, and Riz possibly as well. I might go for this actually. I know usually holding on to the Q is, you do so at your peril, but I only kept hold of it there because of the potential play up there with Q, I, and IF. It might well be taken, but I still have Riz for 32 there. But then I've got the Q dilemma for the next turn, so anyway, let's see how it plays out. I have the O to go in front of BI, so OW. Turp. Is Turp good? OWT. I could even go with N-O-W-T. 37, if Terp is good, I'm not 100% sure of that one. But at a minimum, I could do N-O-W. 29. Okay, he takes that spot, which leaves me with my Q spot. And I've got Zinco, or just Zinc, whichever scores more. Zinco just misses there, the double, so not ideal. Opponent plays HE, so suppose I've got Zinc here. Keeping my O back for a score there. 30 points, not too bad, I guess. Um, was here. 39, it's not bad either. Yeah, I'll go with the Wiz. Right, this looks all right. Must be very close that this would combine with a floater, I would have thought, something cartoned through an E. Seems a bit weak. Dock 26, decent rack. Okay, that's taken. I can still play dock here. Anything across from the A? Del takes. Can't see anything there. Yeah, dock it is, I think. That looks very close. I have the shin component. Have anti prefix. Okay. The non-prefix, yeah, very close. I wonder, am I missing a bingo here? Yeah. Can't see it. No. Looks all right. Okay. It's a bit further away from bingo territory. Now, the TH. Onto an E. Vita here. No, well, I do have the front hook actually. Vita looks all right there. Yeah, not going to do much better than that. Right, J with a whole bunch of consonants. Any hot spots? J plays up here. Nothing to go down there, really. Rejig. Yeah, that seems okay. Any other spots? Terrible rack leave, but score's okay. And that's the problem. I'm going to have to change now, I'd say. Actually, I've got girl here. 10 points, marginally better than changing. Eroints, will it play? Eroints and girls. Oh, what a shame. Okay, it's not looking like a very bingo-friendly board apart from this lane here. Does Aroints have an anagram? Don't think so. I have OY here. Anything else? Wonder what the other option would be, maybe tiny for 22. The other rack leave, I think, slightly better. Provided I draw a vowel. Yeah, I'm going with this 19. Very close. Sternal, but not starnal. I'm not seeing anything. That N doesn't appear to help either. How to resolve it? The L and the R don't have much synergy together. I don't think Geel is good. Maybe just Raj. How many R's to come? One and three T's, so it's definitely Taj. 16. I'm just not getting those vowels. The board is tight, which I suppose does suit me because I have a slight lead. I'll be looking to take that lane out, I think. How to do that? This is also a very dangerous bingo lane here. I have the L for going in front of Obi, Lobi. I could do just pal, maybe. Pal, that'll frustrate the bingo lane a little bit. Verbenas through an A. Okay, opponent does have a play across from the trip, possibly there, and if not, I'll go with Veep. Even though that the floaters might be useful. I don't know, maybe not. I don't have a parallel play there. None of these floaters assist me. Brevets. Brevets. 32. Is that worth doing? Two blanks to come. I do want to go for tile turnover. Score's all right. I don't have a parallel play next to the U here that I can see. I think I'm going with this. And I do draw a blank. So, animate. There'll be a host of bingos here. Animate plays under B. And now it plays up here. Animate for 80. Just want to check if I can maybe get the M doubled. I've got name tag. The M needs to feature later in magenta, name tag, magnate. Can I get the M to feature later in the word? I can't see it all. I'm just going to go with animate. And a K remaining. So opponent definitely has a bingo there, but I have a large enough lead to withstand that one. It's got trodes, anything ending in an R for arb. Yeah, he's got loads of bingos there. Odorate under the B. Adorate. Yeah, so he'll definitely find a bingo. Or deration onto the N would probably be the pick, I'd say. So just wait for opponent to find this bingo. And then we'll go through the examiner. Torsade, okay. And just have a quick look at what we've missed. So it was my opponent to go first. He had sectile and he seemed to miss that bingo. Fluia for 14. Fuki, I considered Fuki. I just wasn't sure about the vowel heaviness of the rack, but I guess it's similar to the equity was actually better with that rack leave, even though I've got a few extra points. So maybe Fuki, I should have stuck with my first play there. Just looking at my own racks. Pod, that was my play. 2 points more, but QI. I was tempted to play it, but I just thought that that hotspot needed to be addressed. Just thought that it wasn't super dangerous, but as it happens, I think it worked out okay. But similar equity. My next rack, I then did play QI, so that was alright. Chi. And then opponent's rack. And Wiz was my play. Azotic. Azotic. From the Z all the way across. Wow. That would have been great. For 54. So, yeah, we have 15 points. It's a big difference. Equity wise, it wasn't a huge difference, but the score, I suppose, because the rack leave is better than NWCONT, but definitely would have gone with Azotic if I spotted it. And my next rack was Doc, which worked out well according to the examiner. And Ordinant. I thought there was a bingo here. Ordinant. So that was a miss. And my play was way down the list there. Nana. So, yeah, Ordinant. And that's a word that I come across quite often in the study. This was opponent's rack. He played Hings. Then Vita was my play, top of the list there, so happy with that. Opponent struggling with racks, as was I here. Rejig appeared best, so that's okay. And then G triple RL, girl. I think I played just the two, but definitely would have played all three if I had spotted that. I do know both versions, but I don't think I've seen the version with the three R's for quite a while, so maybe it didn't occur to me because of that fact. There was opponents, and then Aroints got blocked, unless, I'm still not sure if Girl takes an S, I'll need to check that later, I think it does. I played Oi, which seemed best with a good rack leave, and DN for 16 at 15-8. Playing just Dean. I pronounced that Deanna because of the way the letters are separated. So Dean there for 16, and I think I managed 16 as well. But the rack leave ALNRS, not as good as ALRST. So my next rack was this one, again a challenging one. I played PAL Exchange LNV, which probably would have been a better play to, I thought I was frustrating that lane to protect a 40 point lead, but I don't know if it really has that much strategic merit. As there was another bingo lane available, so you're blocking one, but this was the more likely one to be hit by. But with two blanks still in the bag, I think the examiner is suggesting the exchange as best in that respect. And next rack, Brevets, the 32. 8 more points than the top play by the examiner. but I think the rack leave is very strong. ENRS and the equity, yeah, about 10 points difference in equity, nearly. And then, right, I was way down the list there. 80 points, but 86 on offer for Animate. Of course, Animate starting at I1, M gets doubled, ATE, and it also takes out that bingo lane. So, yeah, I do like that. But happy to spot a bingo anyway, and then opponent went out with Torsade. So that was a good game. Any standout plays? Not particularly. A lot of tricky racks to deal with, which always makes for good practice in how to deal with those situations when you come across them in a tournament, I guess. And the examiner preferred changing on one of the racks, which is interesting there. So that was the end of that one. And hope you enjoyed watching that, and I'll see you next time.